morning, students. Today we are having another lecture for the chapter number 1, the solid state chemistry 12. Yesterday, as earlier, we studied the solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state that are called fluids. Then we described the character of solids and we described homotopes and crystalline. The students, yesterday I have given you some homework on page number 4. 4 questions I have given. Are you prepared? I have given that you have to differentiate between the homotopes and crystalline compounds. The list I have given. Have you completed? Please, if you have not completed, go regular with me, underline the lines and highlighted the subjects which I am giving. Please be regular with me. Now again we are coming to the next topic. Today we are going to describe classification of crystalline solids. Yesterday we studied amorphous and crystalline. As you are knowing that amorphous are short range order. Matlab, we will study only the crystalline solids. Most are crystalline. Most our solid compounds are crystalline in nature. Their characters are first, we can divide all metallic elements like iron, copper, silver, so many metals are in a crystalline. Second, non-metallic. Non-metallic like sulfur, phosphorus, they are non-metallic in crystalline state. Next, compounds like sodium chloride, zinc sulfide and naphthalene, they all are coming in the crystalline state. Now we will classify on basis of intermolecular forces of bonds which appears, that force appears in the particles. We can classify these are, the forces are van der Waals forces, ionic bonds, covalent bonds and metallic bonds. So students, again I am revising the same topic again, as the crystalline solids are classified into metallic, non-metallic and compounds. Again they are classified on the nature of the molecular forces. These are van der Waals forces, ionic bonds, covalent bonds and metallic bonds. We will divide them in 4 categories. Jaise vice versa, molecular, ionic, metallic and covalent. So after we will study first category molecular in a described label. So we are going to start our next topic, the 4 categories: molecular, ionic, metallic and covalent. First we are going to start with the molecular. Molecular solids, first category we are going to start. The first category is divided into non-polar and polar. First one, non-polar. They comprise either atom. For example, you can say that argon, helium are the molecules formed by non-polar covalent bonds. For example, H2CN2 and I2. You are knowing, no? Non-polar. Yani polarity is less. I am describing again the characters. I have given the examples. Now I am saying the characters. The character of non-polar covalent bond are, they held by weak dispersion forces, they are called London forces. Means you can say London forces are dispersion forces. Next character, they are soft. They are non-conductor of electricity. They are soft. They are non-conductor of electricity. Now the third character, their melting points are very low. They are in liquid state at room temperature and pressure. So these were the characters of molecular solids of first category, that is called the non-polar. Now we are coming to the second category in molecular solids, polar, like HCl and H2, like HCl and SO2. Character formed by polar covalent bond. I am saying the character, they are soft, non-conductor of electricity. Third one is, their melting points are higher than polar covalent solids. The examples are SO2 and NH3, they are in solid state. So you can see the difference between the non-polar and polar. Now the third category, that is called the hydrogen bonded molecular solids. Hydrogen bonded molecular solids contain polar covalent bonds between hydrogen and chlorine, nitrogen atoms. Hydrogen and chlorine atoms are oxygen and nitrogen atoms. They contain polar covalent bonds. Their characters are strong hydrogen bond binds molecules of such solids like H2O, jaise ice. In ice, they are having the strong hydrogen bond. The first category was non-polar, second was polar, third one is hydrogen bonded molecular solid. In H2O, ice, there is hydrogen bond. They are having this type of character, non-conductor, or they are non-conductor of electricity. Volatile solids, as ice is going to convert into the water or vapor. Soft solids under room temperature, they are soft solid under room temperature and pressure. Now the second one is ionic solids. First we completed, that is molecular solids. They were polar, non-polar and hydrogen bond. Now we are coming to the second category, that is ionic solids. Ionic solids, they made by three-dimensional arrangements of cations and anions bonds by strong Coulombic forces. They are hard and brittle. They have high MP melting point and boiling points. Ions are not forced to move. They are electrical insulator in solid state. In molten state, are dissolved in water as ions because free they conduct electricity. They are good conductor because as we are going to dissolve, the electrons can move, so they are good conductor of electricity. Now the third one is metallic solids. Metallic solids are their ions are surrounded by free electrons. Their ions are surrounded by free electrons. These electrons are mobile and are evenly spread out throughout the crystal. The ions are free and mobile electrons are responsible for high electrical and thermal conductivity of metals. So you can see in metals there are free electrons. So they are responsible for what? They are responsible for high electrical and thermal conductivity. They are luster, means their upper layer is very soft, shining and color in certain cases. Last one, metals are highly malleable and ductile. So metallic solids have characters of malleable and ductile. They can be made into the sheets and wires. Now the fourth one is covalent of Dankwart solids. Non-metals results from formation of covalent bonds between adjacent atoms throughout the atom. They are also called giant molecules. Covalent bonds are strong and directional in nature. So atoms are held very strongly. Such solids are very hard and brittle. They are having high melting point, decomposed after melting. They are insulated, do not conduct electricity. Their examples are diamond and silicon carbide. Although you know the graphite is also this type of crystals, but it is soft and good and conductor of electricity. So students, today I taught you the four categories. First we studied molecular, next we studied ionic, then we studied. So you can go through the page number ionic, metallic and covalent. Now I am showing you book, the page number 6. I am showing you page number 6. So you can see the diagram of carbon and graphite. Why carbon? Two forms, diamond and graphites, have different structure. So according to the different structures, they are conductor or non-conductor of electricity. So go through nicely this diagram. And on this Next, you can see on page number 6, table 1.2, which I taught in you different paragraphs. It is summarized into the tabular form. You can see the whole table is divided. Types of solids, first molecular, ionic, metallic solids and covalent. Four types which I taught you in paragraph way. Again, you can see the different tables which I taught you in the character form. So, you go through this table nicely and differentiate whole of the chapter, whole of these four categories in a summarized way. So, you practice in this way and you can describe in this way. So, okay students. So, today we finished this, Anna. And again, we are coming to the page number 7. I am giving you some questions like that earlier I have given. I am giving you, so please, if you want to note down, you note down. First question is, classify the following solids in different categories based on the nature of intermolecular forces operating in them. So, first one is potassium sulfate, tin, benzene, urea, ammonia, water, zinc sulfide, graphite, rubidium, argon, silicon carbon. So, carbide. So, please differentiate. Now, the second question. Solid A is very hard electrical insulator in solid as well as in the molten state and metals at extremely high temperature. What type of solid is it? Third one, ionic solids conduct electricity in molten state but not in solid state. Explain. Now the last question, what type of solids are electrical conductors? Malleable and ductile, which I taught you last. So please continue. These, practice these four questions and whole of the two pages which I taught you, go through nicely, underline all these topics which I taught you, underline, highlight and do the MCQs practice also. So you will be eligible for the question number 1, MCQs and remaining in the subscription way, question number 2 and 3. So please, students.